Podcast recording starts in 3, 2, 1.
Hey everyone, you are listening to On Manorama's Wacky News. My name is Adira Madhav and I'm here to bring you some of the craziest news stories this week. Joining me is my beloved robot Manorama, who collects all these crazy stories.
Can I take a break this week? I am trying to learn some tongue twisters.
You're a robot. You don't have a tongue. What's the point then?
That's what I am trying to learn. To twist my non-existent tongue to make it sound funny. Do you know the toughest tongue twister, according to the Guinness Book of World Records?
No. What is it?
The sixth sick shakes sixth sheep sick. Go on, try saying it.
The sixth sick shakes... The sick shakes... Nope, I can't do it.
The sixth sick shakes sixth sheep sick. See, I am jealous of you. Unlike you, I am always getting it right.
Yeah, such a show off, yeah? Stop this nonsense and start the news countdown.
Fine. 10.
When life gives you lemons, make batteries. That's right. Royal Society of Chemistry earned a Guinness World Record when their battery made from 2,923 lemons generated around 2,000 volts of electricity. This international organization of scientists cut the lemons in half to make the electrolyte and hooked strips of zinc and copper to each end as electrodes to extract a total of 2,307.8 volts from the fruit. The lemon battery was then used to activate an LED attached to a light sensor that triggered a relay and activated a pyrotechnic system to kick off a go-kart race.
I know a tongue twister about lemons. Can you say this? Life lent me lemons, and I labored labeling lemonade laden with the lemons life lent laboriously to me.
No thanks. I don't wish to give the audience more reason to think I'm stupid.
9.
Animal Welfare League of Arlington recently captured a wandering chicken caught sneaking around a security area at the Pentagon. The loose hen was found near the US Department of Defense headquarters and it has been named Henny Penny. The animal welfare organization also joked that the answer to why the chicken crossed the road was to get to the Pentagon.
The chicken checkers ought to check the chickens that the chicken catchers caught.
What was that?
I wanted to give you a chicken-themed tongue twister, but I guess you are too chicken to try it. 8.
A US man from Idaho claims that he has completed his goal of breaking 52 world records in a single year. Author and entertainer David Rush set out to break 52 Guinness World Records in 2021, and so far, the organization has verified 43 of them. He is now the world's fastest juggler, the world's slowest juggler, fastest 100-meter blindfolded, fastest 100-meter juggling with three objects blindfolded, and so on. David said that he started his Record a Week mission to inspire students who struggle with science, technology, engineering, and mathematics fields by showing difficult things are possible.
How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
I don't know, but I'm sure Mr. David Rush will break that woodchuck's record next year.
7.
Minnie Mouse is getting a wardrobe makeover. Minnie Mouse is trading her iconic red dress for a pantsuit designed by British fashion designer Stella McCartney. Minnie's new sartorial statement will be unveiled in March to commemorate International Women's Day and the 30th anniversary of Disneyland Paris. According to Disney, McCartney was chosen to create the look because of her legacy of female leadership as well as her commitment to sustainability.
I hope Mickey Mouse wears a little black dress and destroy gender stereotypes in clothing. 6.
555.55 carat black diamond has been unveiled by Sotheby's auction house in Dubai. The rare gem named the Enigma is believed to have come from the outer space, either created from a meteoric impact or a diamond-bearing asteroid collided with the Earth. According to Sotheby's, this sale represents a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to acquire one of the rarest billion-year-old cosmic wonders known to humankind. I should also tell you that this diamond costs around 50 crore rupees. Manorama, do you have a tongue twister to accompany this news?
Sadly, no. I think the price of the diamond left me tongue-tied. 5.
The market value of Facebook's parent company, Meta, plunged by $240 billion this week as the company's share crashed by 26%. According to the CEO of Kotak Mahindra Bank, Uday Kotak, that is more than the total value of India's largest company. India's most valued company, Reliance, only has a market capitalization of around $210 billion. Mark Zuckerberg's net worth also slipped below Gautam Adani and Mukesh Ambani. Mark said that the company was navigating a tricky transition from social networking towards the virtual world of metaverse.
Navigating to avoid all that bad press, lawsuits, and negative publicity must also be very tricky.
4. The most recent roadmap for decommissioning the International Space Station was published this week. The plan is to bring the space station out of orbit in January 2031 by plunging it into a watery grave in a remote area of the Pacific Ocean. NASA is now exploring ways to get the private sector more involved in the space industry. Though the billionaire space race turned into a publicity disaster, experts believe the race could make private space travel commercially viable.
Hope these billionaires won't turn NASA into a travel agency.
3. A new type of South Korean face mask that only covers the wearer's nose is creating a lot of controversies. Face mask called KOSK, a combination of KO, the Korean word for nose, and mask, is sold by the South Korean company Atman. They are designed to provide some level of protection against COVID while eating. Some health experts call this mask utterly useless, but some others believe that nose-only masks are better than not wearing a mask at all.
It would be easier if they stuffed two cotton balls inside the nose and walked around.
2. The Keep Sweden Tidy Foundation estimates that more than 1 billion cigarette butts are littered every year in Sweden, constituting about 62% of all litter. Since teaching humans not to throw cigarettes on the ground has proved impossible, a Swedish startup has now trained wild crows to pick up cigarette butts in exchange for food. The founder of Corvid Cleaning, Christian Gunther Hansen, said crows were very easy to teach and there is also a high chance they learn from each other. Moreover, he insisted that crows are participating in this experiment voluntarily.
A day will come when robots treat humans the same way humans treat animals.
Manorama, you're scaring me.
1.
The New York Times has acquired the website-only word game Wordle from its creator Josh Wardle for an undisclosed amount. In its initial announcement, the Times said that Wordle, currently hosted on an ad-free site, would be free to play when it moves to their platform. Since this is an initial announcement, does this mean that the game would only initially remain accessible to the players? I mean, a New York Times game subscription, which includes the daily crossword puzzle, currently costs like $5 a month. That's like 400 bucks in Indian money.
Maybe I should stop this tongue twister business and develop my own AI-powered Wordle.
Manorama, sweetie, can I also play?
I will share my Wordle on one condition.
What?
Say this, if Peter Piper picked a pack of pickled peppers, where's the pack of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked?
Peter Piper picked a pick a pepper. Ugh, forget it. I'm going to play snakes in my Nokia 3310.